Good afternoon, and thank you for joining us. We are just 4 days away from early voting beginning here in Minnesota. Recent KARE 11 Star Tribune NPR poll surveyed 800 Minnesotans, and right now we're checking out how they feel about the race for Minnesota Attorney General. Incumbent Democrat Keith Ellison is leading Republican challenger Jim Scholz by just 1.5 points. Ellison's lead is stronger in the Hennepin-Ramsey County area, 68% to 20%. Scholz leads in the metro suburbs, southern Minnesota, and northern Minnesota. In those three areas, more than 50% of the people polled said that they would vote for the Republican candidate. In each region, 7 to 10% of voters are still undecided. We spoke to a couple of voters about their thoughts on this race.
His priorities kind of align with where we want to go and what we need.
Keith Ellison, if he were anybody else or any other party, he wouldn't have been elected.
Early voting starts September 23rd and ends on November 7th. An alleged accomplice to the Mall of America shooter will be in court today. Delaney Arnold is charged with helping two people escape after the shooting back in August. Investigators say the two suspects, Rashad May and Shamar Lark, were taken to Arnold's house right after the shooting. Then they went to Chicago, where they were arrested. Lark is charged with the actual shooting, and May is facing aiding an offender charge. No one was hurt in that incident, but the mall was forced into lockdown and had to close early that day. Eight Minnesota schools are being recognized today as Blue Ribbon Schools from the U.S. Department of Education. The awards are split into two categories, Exemplary High Performing Schools and Exemplary Achievement Gap Closing Schools. Six schools fit the high performing category, two of which are in the metro, Seven Hills Preparatory Academy in Bloomington and Kimberly Lane Elementary School in Plymouth. Lake Middle School in Woodbury was one of the two Minnesota schools recognized for closing the achievement gap. Right now, more than a million people are waking up without power in Puerto Rico after a hurricane named Fiona slammed into the island. The Category 1 hurricane made landfall over the weekend. Ben Derry joining us from the backyard right now, and they sure don't need that down there, do they?
No, absolutely. Some places getting more than a foot of rain. So, yeah, it's an amazing storm system that's now pushing back out into open water. Should become a major hurricane, a Category 3 storm within the next day or so before it starts to impact places like Bermuda later this week. Now, around our neck of the woods, we did start off the day with quite a bit of fog. That fog has since lifted, and we are seeing sunshine now, and it looks like we'll stay on the sunny side through the remainder of the day. Right now, 74 degrees. We're already warmer than we were all day yesterday as that wind turns southerly and that sun still has plenty of power to it. We are tracking some showers across the northern part of the state this early afternoon. That'll stay well to our north. And again, sunny sky for us through the afternoon. Late tonight, there's a warm front that pushes through. We might see a few showers or garden variety thunderstorms develop over the east central part of the state, pushing into western Wisconsin after midnight. And you can see those storms continue to track east as we head into Tuesday. So temperatures both today and tomorrow likely reaching the 80s before a big cold front moves through Tuesday evening. That'll knock our temperatures back into the 60s and even 50s for parts of northern Minnesota by Wednesday and Thursday. So a big transition from summer-like conditions into fall as the official start of fall begins on Thursday. By the way, Rena, next best chance for rain here in the metro is Friday, especially Friday afternoon. Back to you.
My goodness, that is a big drop from 87
to 20 degrees. Yeah.
And that's probably usual this time of year, right?
Yeah, we'll see that. We'll see if we can get another 80 or two before they're done for the season.
All right. Here's hoping. Thanks, yeah. Ben. And make sure to download the KARE 11 weather app. You can get personalized forecasts, weather alerts, and check the live radar anytime. It's free in every app store. Well, it may feel like COVID numbers here are going down, but the recent wastewater numbers show that it is not the case in Minnesota. So could we see another fall COVID surge? And do mixed messages from our political leaders leave many confused? We're going to break all of that down for you coming up tonight at 6. That's going to do it for us for now, but we'll see you back here in 25 minutes for more news and weather updates. We'll